Hello, FHTM family. Hope you're doing well today. I'm taking a break today, as we all are. You're going to meet our advisory council today. We're kind of in between meetings and just wanted you to meet some of the people that are helping keeping your company between the white lines, so to speak. I'm going to turn it over to Keith Kuder, who's general counsel here at the company, and he's going to talk to these individuals, Bob, Chris, and Alan, that they're really helping us in a great big way and helping you keep our company once again between the white lines. Keith?
Thank you, Paul. So, gentlemen, obviously you're members of our advisory council, and we've had you in to talk about what's coming with FHTM. But I want the folks out there to have a sense of what your involvement with FHTM means for each of you. So, starting with you, Chris. Chris is the chairman of the advisory council. For you, why don't you tell the folks, what is the role of the advisory council?
Well, Keith, as you know, I'm a former attorney general of the state of Kentucky, and the role of the council is to make sure that we comply with the rules and the regulations of the states, the Federal Trade Commission, all government regulations. And I think you could really condense that in the fact that a lot of it is technical, but a lot of it really gets to a value system of treating people the same way that you want to be treated. And so what we do is go through the procedures, make sure that we're complying with the laws of all the states as they relate to multi-level marketing companies, and basically make sure that we dot all the I's and cross all the T's.
Thank you, Chris. And one of the other members of our advisory council is Robert Steffen. And Bob, I'd like to ask you, what is it about FHTM that led you to want to join the advisory council?
Well, as Kansas Attorney General for 16 years, I dealt with multi-level marketing companies, some good and some bad, and I was contacted by Paul Orberson to consider being a consultant or advisor to the company, and he certainly made me realize that his interest was in directing the company in the right way and in the right direction, and I thought maybe I could assist with that.
Thank you, Bob. The newest member of the advisory council is Alan Luce. Alan Luce has been in the direct selling industry for 40 years, and so I think it would be a good question for the folks to hear from you. What do you see as the hallmarks of a great direct selling company?
Well, I've had the privilege of working for a number of the top companies like Tupperware and Party Light, also starting companies of my own, and being very actively engaged with the Direct Selling Association as a past chairman. There's three elements to creating a great direct selling company. The first one is you have to have good products and services that people feel are a fair value for what they receive. The second is you have to have an understandable and transparent compensation plan that makes people feel they're fairly rewarded for what they do. And the third thing is you have to have a management team that is dedicated to doing the right things. Now, the right things is larger than just doing what the law requires. It goes to what Chris was talking about. What is the right thing to make this sales force proud of what they're doing, proud of who they represent, and proud of the opportunity to other people to join them? I was convinced that this management team has that determination. And so, like Bob, if I could be of some assistance, I was willing to do so, and I'm happy to be here.
Thanks to each of you gentlemen for coming to Lexington today and every month that you come. And I'm proud to be represented by these gentlemen, and I know you are now, as you have heard from them. But we'll look forward to meeting them at convention. And I'll look forward to seeing many of you, thousands of you, in Knoxville, Tennessee this weekend on Saturday as we come up on May 19th. God bless you as you build your FHTM business.